Bat Guy Flies RC. Okay, this is going to be the rates, radio, and CG setup, radio rates and CG setup for the Flightline F4U Corsair. And as I normally do, first thing we start off with is CG. CG is 100 millimeters back from the leading edge of the wing. So that puts it right at the beginning of this panel line right here. And if you look underneath the plane, if you look at this panel line that's right here, it's right before this panel line. I've made a little indentation there. So 100 millimeters back, pretty simple to remember. Got the gear down, slightly nose heavy. Let's turn it over. And yes, I do have the prop on in the man cave, but it's kind of hard to show y'all CG, proper CG on this thing without the prop, without that big old stinking heavy prop on there. And that's pretty good. Now let's put the gear up. And they rotate in. Watch them doors. Okay. Put our right there at that panel line, right there at that panel line. Pretty perfect right there. Let's turn her over. And this way, because I've heard for every person that tells me you should do CG with the gear down, I've had the same amount of people tell me you should have CG with the gear up. And personally, I think it should be the gear up because that's the way you're flying. Okay, now on the panel line there, she's kind of sort of wanting to be slightly nose headed for me. So that's exactly what I want. So 100 millimeters back is perfect CG. Okay. Watch your doors. Pay attention to how long those things take. Okay. Still don't know what those extra springs were for. Now, you say, well, that's fine and dandy, Mr. Fat Guy, but what about inside the plane? What that equates to is extremely simple. Shove your 5000 as far as forward as you can get it. Okay? I got a graphene 5000 as far forward as you can possibly get it. Okay? I've also got the 7-channel. I mean, you can't get any further. I got a 7-channel Lemon RX Gen 2 right there with the stabilization on. Just AS3X, and then I've got an antenna up underneath here with antennas going this way, and this back here has an antenna going straight down, then one straight back. So I've got 9 degrees, and I have no problem with the range. She passed her range test with extra 10 feet added, and she still passed her range test, so no problem at all. All right, so now we've covered CG. We've covered my radio setup. I've got 11RX, 7-channel. I've also utilized the reverse function. I have that set up on my C-switch. I'm away from my prop, but with my C-switch down, my reverse enabled. Okay, that's backwards. And then there's forwards. And there's backwards. I'm away from the prop. Okay, I'm very well aware. But in normal cruise mode, my stabilization is on. Okay, I've got a maximum throws. Okay, I'm set for, it's either very much, very obvious. Okay, so now I can take, I'm being very careful not to hit that throttle. I got throttle cut on. So now I can turn those gains down on that knob. It automatically defaults to your eighth channel, eight auxiliary, and now I've turned them down a little bit, and I can go even further down than that. I can go even further down, and basically, they're almost completely off now. All right. To talk about rates. Set it up by the book. This is a big plane, so trying to maneuver around to show you everything is not all that easy to do. Okay. By the book, luckily for us Spectrum guys, they're giving us percentages now. So our low, this is interesting, low rate and high rate on the ailerons is 100%. Okay, that's 100%. It doesn't give you any suggestion for Expo, but I use 30% Expo on everything. Okay, for high rate on elevator is only 75. Okay, which is what that looks like. And then low rate is 50, which is what that looks like. You got to remember, you think, well, that's not much. 50 is not much, but that's a big control surface. Okay. Rudder, high rate on rudder is 65. I'm sorry, high rate's 100. Low rate is 65. There's low rate. Okay. Here's high rate. Higher rates 100%, 30% Expo. So everything, so your rudder and your ailerons 100% for high. Your low on your ailerons still 100%, 30% Expo. That's my Expo's me. Rudder is 100% high and 65% low. And then you just pick you a number somewhere in the middle of that, of all that, if you want to have a mid rate. And your elevator, though, however, is the one that's different. The low rate is 50. Okay. And the high rate is 75. All right, that's low. Okay, and there's high, because it is an awfully big control surface. Okay. All right. Timer will be set for 5 minutes for the initial flight. And remember, your doors are sequenced. Okay, let's talk about flaps now. Take a look at your flaps. Now, they don't give you percentages. That is... actually, let me turn it like that. Okay, that is takeoff flaps, or position one in the manual, and that is landing flaps. Now, if you take your ruler and you measure from the inside structure down to here, that should be 33 millimeters for your landing flaps. For your flaps up, or your takeoff flaps, that should be 20 millimeters from the inside structure down to there. Same thing on the other side, obviously. Now, and then of course flaps up are all the way up. Now, to show it, to tell you what that equates to on a Spectrum, because it's not in percentages, I mean, it's in percentages, not fractions, to show you what that looks like, okay. For flaps up, okay, let me get moved over here just a little bit, sorry. Okay, for flaps up, I know we're getting positioned here, because I have to be able to see the camera on what I'm telling you. For flaps up is a negative 100. Now, the instructions say nothing about a flap to elevator mix, so I'm not going to put one in until I fly it. For takeoff flaps, you're going to put, to equate that to Spectrum, you're going to put a negative 30. And that's what that looks like. That's that 20 millimeters down. And then for landing, you're going to put in a positive 50 on a Spectrum. And that's what that looks like. So let me show you that again. Hopefully you can. Okay, just watch that one flap. Okay, flaps up. Again, negative 100. Takeoff. Negative 30, landing is a positive 50. Okay. All right, we've covered rates. We've covered CG. Okay, we've covered my timer. We've covered the radio setup, the placement of the radio. I'd put an antenna or a satellite in there. So really, it's a pretty simple airplane. It's not much to do. I didn't go over hooking up the linkages because you're going to use your two shortest push rods on your ailerons. The other four are on your flaps. Hook up with your aileron Okay, with your shortest one, make sure it's level here when you hook it up. This should not be your first plane, and you should already know how to do this. Just hook up your first one here, make sure it's level, and then follow your flaps all the way in. So everything, this should line up with this, this should line up with that, and therefore it's going to line up pretty close to the fuse. And it mirrors the same thing on the other side. Start at the ailerons and work your way in, making sure that they're trim and level with each other. And they're pretty darn close. And there again, it's bench trim. You don't know if this plane is trim until you get in the air. Bench trim is your starting point. Trimeter in flight is where you really find out whether she's trimmed or not. Okay? I didn't have to adjust the push rods that much. They were pretty close. Make sure the elevators back here in the inside the airplane, you have a 1.5 millimeter hex drive that you can loosen the push rods. Okay, for this, go ahead and loosen those both up, hook up both your aileron or your elevator ball links and your rudder. Make sure that your rudder is perfect and then tighten it down inside. Make sure your elevator is perfectly level right here. The book doesn't say anything about making sure that elevator is up or down. Just making sure it's level. Okay, it doesn't get to know. It shows it, pretty well shows it being just the way I've got it. Straight even with each other, just like that. Okay, and then tighten down those linkages. Now let me show you. These linkages, they're right on top, but I'm going to have to grab you, and we're going to go flying. So hold on to your hats. Hold on to your lunch. Okay. All right. Okay. There's your rudder. When you're setting, when you're putting it up, go ahead and loosen that up so that that push rod slides in and out. This is your elevator. Make sure both these, just loosen that up and slide them out. Just enough where they can be moved, not to where you they move freely. Just enough where you can move the control surface back there, you know, back there. And then that way you can adjust. And when you've got them, you know, tight enough where they have a little bit of grab, that way you kind of have to move physically move the control surface back there. That way it kind of holds the position and then come up here. And then when everything's nice and tight, and everything's nice and level the way you want it, then you anchor those back down. If you don't get it right, loosen it up, reposition, start over. Okay? And that's really all you have to do. It's not hard at all. I think that's, oh, actually, that's the Phillips head screwdriver that does that, not a hex drive. All right. Like I said, yes, I know I've got the prop on, but in order to show you CG, this thing's... The prop's heavy. Okay, the prop it definitely would affect your CG. Put a 5,000 straight, all slam it all the way forward, and you shouldn't have any problem. That's what everyone that I read about says. It says put a 5,000 all the way forward, and you won't have to put any weight in there. CG's 100 millimeters back from the leading edge of the wing, and she's a heavy bird. She's fair. I mean, she's a fairly heavy bird, but. She should fly floaty. That big old beautiful wing on there. So, anyways, let me get her turned around here real quick. End the video with her presentation. Now, I did screw up on the decals. If you're looking closely, if you know anything about Corsairs, I put the big stars and bars on the side. You get four of them, but there's another decal sheet that I was on the bottom. I didn't notice it. You put smaller stars and bars, and then you put these yellow stripes through the back. But I had already applied the big ones on here. Other than that, I followed the instructions, but I thought that was only one. I said, boy, they sure look big. Where am I going to put them yellow stripes? And so I didn't want to add insult to injury and make small yellow stripes, so I just left it alone. And I made it evenly on the other side. So if I screw up on one side, I went ahead and made the screw up on the other. And I tried to pull it off, but started pulling paint off. And I'd rather live with a big decal instead of having to repaint it. So the only other thing I'm going to do is I mentioned in the bills, I'm going to do a clear coat on her. And I am going to do the glossy finish that may not be I know probably the mat would be better, but I don't have a mat. And those cans are $13 each, and I've already got three or four cans of the glossy. So you got suspension, and she's an absolutely gorgeous bird, and I cannot wait to get a maiden for you. All right, folks. Well, thank you so much for watching. This is the Rates Radio and CG setup for the Flightline F4U Corsair. God bless y'all. God is good. And don't forget, faith, family, and friends, and then big old honking warbirds. Bye, y'all.